show, I'm going to give Craig Sawyer the floor in the next 12 minutes. And then I'm going to have David Knight come in here for another 6-7 minutes and ask his questions. I'm going to be gone. I got to go literally walk in here on this other meeting. But I know this. The president wants to go after these people. It's happening. It's really scaring them. We've got our reporters out in the field in California. But Craig Sawyer, a former Navy SEAL, contractor, federal officer, you name it. Craig, wow, just the last 5-6 days, all hell's breaking loose. They're really scared of you and others and your team. Let's tell folks what's been unfolding.
Well, I got to admit, I'm flattered that that such big groups are that concerned about little old me and my team. And all we're about is exposing that which has been so successfully suppressed for so long. So, a high-level source of mine said that internet chatter right now is, since I launched the organization to help expose this pedophilia ring going on nationwide, globally actually, but we're focused here in the United States. There's two specific groups already out there freaking out, panicking, worried about me and what I bring, which is exposure, and looking to discredit us. So they got three initial things that they want to come at us for, and it's not a surprise. We knew that this would be par for the course. We anticipated and expected this as standard, to be honest with you, in the political realm. So, but the first thing they want to do is discredit our crowdfunding or our funding, whichever method we do, and then they want to bring legal attacks, whatever that may be, and then they want to smear me, bring false slanderous attacks against me. So I say, hey, bring it, man. That's what we signed up for. This is coming. We're not going to shut up. We're not the kind of guys that get scared and go away, man. I surrounded myself by guys that I've known for a long time that are anything but scared. So we're ready, come what may.
Well, let me say this
again: is expose the harm to children that has been kept quiet.
Let me say this: we've got a fellow here that has been involved in the rescues and things that are going on today, who is going to go public because he thinks that'll give him tactics and stuff. I think they already know we're coming for him, but I'm going to have that discussion in about 10 minutes, and I'm going to turn it over to you for another 10 minutes or so with David Knight. But I heard from my friend who's here today. He heard Glenn Beck, and I checked with my source. Glenn Beck came out and said his number one goal would be to stop pedophilia and sex slavery in America, and he's going to lead it with some group called the Underground Railroad. Well, I'm not going to bash that group. I asked my source, is that a good group? He goes, no, it's a total diversion. Now, I'm not bashing anybody that's worked with it or hasn't worked with it. The point is I work with the real people that are actually involved, 3,000 arrests. They're finding the kids. They're finding all the sex slavery, and then nothing is ever in the news after it. So regardless, the point is, Glenn Beck himself represents himself as a patriot. He always comes in to take over anything we're doing so he can then discredit it later. And I'm not going to bash Glenn on every front. Maybe he's decided to stop being a bad guy. Maybe Underground Railroad's great. All I can tell you is the people I'm working with, and Craig Sawyer and others, most of them unnamed, are 100% on target. And I just asked my other source, because I thought I'd call him in, because I heard about this from, again, a year ago, 6 months ago. He was going on missions all over the world. I said, is Craig Sawyer good? He goes, oh, absolutely, of course. So the point is, we're just vetting all of this because, the fact is the enemy's got infiltrators in here.
Yeah, that's one of their tactics, the classic honeypot technique and other operations that they run. They want to find out on the inside what we're doing and cause a disruption. Because, look, they are murdering and torturing children to death. So how are they going to defend that to any sane human being? So if I bring an honest effort with a clean background toward them to simply tell the truth, that's a real threat to what they're doing. So what can they do? All they can do is run around, throwing smoke and trying to divert and distract and hide. But this time it's not going to go away. There's no place to hide. We're going to bring this. We've got a president that'll back us, a DOJ that'll back us, that's not all about pedophilia for once. And it looks like we've got everything that we need, minus the funding. The funding's coming, and we appreciate everybody that's rallying behind us. But our thing, and we're not competing with any of the other groups out there for how many busts or territory or anything like that. What my organization is about is exposure. And we can coordinate with and even assist the other units.
No, I totally agree.
Is telling the tale.
In fact, I didn't bring up this other group in Glenn Beck. Because I don't know them. I just know Beck's a bad actor. And then the other group I mentioned to somebody, and they go, oh, my God, absolutely, just a total diversion. I'm not saying they're bad. They just are all talk. And then I asked my other sources, I said, well, is, you know, Craig Ray? He goes, oh, absolutely. So all I'm getting is we just, it's not about who donates money where. I'm not making any money off this. I'm giving my money. You're giving your money, Craig. It's all about funding this operation to do the final missing link. Exactly. You have the law enforcement military ready to cover it, ready to show you the findings when it's not getting covered by media, when the bust happened. We're about bringing real sunshine to this, proving how widespread it is. And I know you can't get into sources and methods and things, but, I mean, let's talk about this type of stuff we're witnessing. I mean, you wouldn't get into it Sunday. Can you tell people a little bit?
Well, again, we don't want to let them know too much about what we're doing, what's going on, but what we're watching, and we've got access to federal and local law enforcement to observe and participate in what's going on and, again, tell it to the American public. And the reason we are striking such fear into the hearts of the two groups specifically that are panicking right now at the launch of Veterans for Child Rescue.
Can we say the name? I mean,
one is the Muslim Brotherhood. Now they self-identify. I never mentioned the Muslim Brotherhood as we're going after them, because we're not going after them. We're going after those who harm children, and we know that there are people that do that are in just about every group. And then it's the other is the head of one of our major political parties. So do the math. Which political party has no moral standards? Which, you know, political party booed the name of God out of their convention campaign and so forth? So it's not hard to figure out. And I'm not out to start a war with any political party, but
they declared war on us.
I don't care where they are. We're going to expose them no matter who they are. People are asking me, Saul, are you just going to go after the low-level guys? And absolutely not, man. We're going to go after the biggest fish there are. That's the whole idea. Otherwise, why bother? It's not worth my time. Look, if we can save one child, it's worth
all
of it.
Yeah, we need to cut the head off the snake.
Go big.
We need to cut the head off the snake.
Yes, sir. Yep. And I think a part of it, too, is just inspiring the American people to realize, hey, look, we the American patriot, are still the overwhelming majority. We, the basically moral, decent, Judeo-Christian American, are still the overwhelming majority. We hold the power, and we hold the will, and we hold the numbers. So let us no longer sit back and be quiet and just allow this to happen to the youth, what I call the soul of our nation. They're doing this on a widespread basis. They're attacking our children. They're shattering the little kids' lives, and it's horrible. And so I ask people to make a decision. Either you are for harming children, toddlers and infants, and torturing them to death, or you are against that. It's easy to decide which side of this you're on. So no longer can you sit back and go, oh, I don't know, this is just a sexual deviancy. Some people prefer this. The child does not prefer this. The child cannot get away. The child cannot say, I decline and I want to go outside because I don't like being tortured. I'm in pain. And I don't want to die tonight. I don't want to be raped anymore because I'm two years old. A child doesn't have the power to speak for themselves. So the people have to speak for them. So that's why my organization needs the backing of the American public.
Well, everything I've got is for the children, because I've got three children, about to have a fourth child, and it's all about life. It's all about committing, and I know how real this is, and I know the president is concerned. So almost 70,000 there, 50 on the other, and I'm going to give another 90. Everybody should donate at gunfund.me.
As you heard in the last segment, he pointed out that there is now organized opposition to him coming from the Muslim Brotherhood, from a political party, leaders in a political party. So I want to just let Craig break this down as to what the state of this is. And I didn't hear the beginning of the interview. Craig, I don't know if you have an address yet that's out that public that people can donate to. I know I've had a lot of people contact me on Twitter wanting that information. So if you've got that, it's a good time to give that out. There we go. I see it up there now.
We do. It's on our website. This is the funding page, but on our website, vetsforchildrescue.org, there's all the new mailing information. So if somebody wants to do that,
good,
rather
good.
Than go through the online, they're welcome to that now.
Great. And that's very important, because as we saw, first we had GoFundMe, so they didn't want to, basically were non-responsive to everything. You got on with You Caring. And then as you came on with Alex Jones last week, within an hour or two, they completely shut you down. But let's talk about what you want to talk about, where this goes from here, what you're seeing right now. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, it's interesting with our counter intel and other assets out there picking up on the chatter on from high-level sources on the internet, seeing who's self-identifying as scumbags who harm children. We're after saving the children from predators, from those who rape and murder them. And it's interesting to see two groups specifically respond to that and assume it's them, and even formulating their attacks against our org. So I'm like, hey, man, if I'm the threat to the bad guys, I'm very honored and I'm very proud of that. I'm ready to tie into it right now. So
hey, look, as soon as you start talking about child abuse, I say, you're talking about me? You're talking about me? I mean, that's kind of like, self-identifying,
it's
isn't
so
it?
Telling. I'm like, okay, well, thanks for yeah. revealing your position on that. Thanks for telling the American public where you stand.
Yeah.
On children. You hate the children. You want to attack the children. Okay, noted. Now, as far as the operations, what we're looking to do with the exposure piece, I want all law enforcement out there to know that we are not out to expose your specific techniques or our specific techniques. We are going to tell the story, and we're going to show a little bit about what goes on, because what we need to do is bring the public in on it. People need to kind of see what's happening that they're not seeing on the mainstream media. We need to show them a little bit more of the truth of what's going on day to day, night to night out there. But we are not looking to compromise any operational security or undermine any operations. Look, a federal criminal investigator myself and a counterterrorist operator from the highest level. So I understand OPSEC, and we're your ally. So in case, and I haven't gotten any of that, but in case anybody ever had any concerns, hey, we're for the good guys.
Very important. Yeah, you're not going to compromise any ongoing investigations or tactics.
That's our background. That's what makes us tick, man. So we just want to protect the kids. And I think any decent human being that's not insane or has not, like, deliberately done some weird thing where they've sold their soul to the devil can agree that we should not be torturing our infants to death.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
if you're, yeah. you know.
But of course, we've seen this when we look at it in the UK and we look at the case of Seville. And what was happening was we saw people at lower levels of Scotland Yard open up multiple investigations of him, and then they were shut down by the higher-ups. And the same thing happened at the BBC. As soon as the guy died, people knew what was going on. They did a documentary, and then the higher-ups of the BBC shut it down. So that's what we're going against. It isn't the rank-and-file people. They see this. They're offended by this. But it's the people at the upper levels that shut this down.
Yeah, well, it's the weak who abuse their authority. And it's the weak who resort to this kind of desperate caper or scheme to try to gain power in this world. It's disappointing. It would be laughable except for the victims who are very real and the absolute torture and torment that so many children are enduring. Mm. So when I have exposed and blown the whistle on federal crooks in the past out of practical necessity, what I saw in the process is that the exposure is what they feared most. That is what they could not control. They had friends across the federal government that were crooks that would allow them to do whatever they were doing, but they didn't control those who were going straight to the media. So I'm like, aha, I see you. I see how you crooks function. I see what shakes your pathetic little coward carcass right to the bone as exposure, because what you're doing so despicable and unacceptable that you can't bear to have it known. So we're going to make it known.
That's right. You've got to shine shine light on these cockroaches. It's very
shine
important. Give out that website one more time where people can make contributions.
It is vetsforchildrescue.org.
Very good. And that's where people can go directly to contribute to this. Very important. Thank you so much, Craig Sawyer, for your efforts.